Situated on the mid-Atlantic ridge, Iceland is a hotspot of volcanic and geothermal activity. Fed by snowmelt and a melting glaciated ice cap, Iceland is riddled with rivers and creeks spilling from the highlands into the sea in every direction. These tumbling waterways are a kayaker's mecca, featuring everything from low-volume creeks to thunderous, glacial-fed rivers. This year, I teamed up with A-list paddlers and close friends Rush Sturges, Tyler Bratt, and Patrick Camblin. Our mission? To circumnavigate the land of fire and ice in search of previously unrun waterfalls. Well, we've started this trip much the way we start most trips when we come to new countries. We spend a day or so just getting all our stuff together, running a few chores and kitting ourselves up to basically head westwards around the western fjords of Iceland. It's a place that hasn't really been explored too much from a kayaking perspective. I've probably driven 100 kilometres out of Reykjavik heading west. It's good to be here and we're all feeling pretty excited about what we're going to find, you know. It's like no place I've ever been on Earth. It's sort of devoid of any tree life, but it's just custom built for kayaking. There's the highlands in the middle of the country covered in snow. Then you get these cliffs dropping off the highlands and just in front of us is the sea, you know, with the road going right around the whole circumference of the country. So it really is just custom made for kayaking, and it's great to be here with a cool group of guys and just get excited about exploring places that none of us have ever been before, and really looking forward to what we might find. Summertime in Iceland. 12:06 a.m. Midnight sun. Well, we've spent the last couple of days traveling around the western fjords of Iceland, and we've seen just a countless number of waterfalls and rapids coming tumbling off the highlands that basically border the coastline. I think that we all feel that with every next corner we drive around, there's always a potential of a huge waterfall being custom made for kayaking. So pretty excited about what we're seeing and what potentially we're going to find, and it's all part of exploring and coming to new places and trying to find new rapids and waterfalls. So I've spent the last couple of days pretty much driving northwest around the western fjords of Iceland, and it's an area that had been previously pretty unexplored from a kayaking point of view. We found just countless waterfalls and rapids spilling out of the highlands down into the ocean, but we've started to move into the mainland a little bit more, and the volume of the rivers has really started to pump up noticeably, and every single valley we drive up, there's just mountains towering over us, there's waterfalls flowing in, and we're starting to definitely get pretty excited. We're just coming into the foot of another fjord, and as per normal, there's another huge waterfall here that we're climbing up to have a look at, and filled with anticipation to what we might find. So pretty excited about the next few days of our adventure around Iceland.
Crush a bit, little bit, roll it up, take a hit. Feeling lit, feeling right, 2 a.m. summer night. I don't care, hand on the wheel,
Driving drunk, I'm doing my thing. Rolling the mid beside him now. Living my life, getting our dreams. People told me slow my roll. I'm screaming out, fuck that. I'ma do just what I want. Looking ahead, no turning back. If I fall, if I die, know I lived it to the fullest. If I fall, if I die, know I lived in missing bullets.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good.
Tell me what you know. Dreaming, dreaming, you don't really know about nothing, nothing. Tell me what you know about the night terrors every night. 5 a.m. cold sweats waking up to the sky. Tell me what you know about dreams, dreams. Tell me what you know about night terrors, nothing. You don't really care about the trials of tomorrow. Rather lay awake in the bed full of sorrow.
I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always gonna be gold. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine ain't always.
Always go. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good.
So we have sort of rounded up the western and northern fjord part of our travels around Iceland, and now we've made our way towards the northeast. It's a lot colder up here. You know, at the moment we're in the middle of an ice field. We camped last night and the howling wind and freezing cold temperatures, but you know, once again it's just been proven that Iceland is a country of all types of weather, all types of landscapes, and all types of rivers and waterfalls.
Man, look, wind been blowing on my back. I was born to bring trouble wherever I'm at. Got a number 13 tattooed on my neck. That ink starts to itch, black gon' turn to red. I was born in the soul of misery.
Driving up every river valley we could possibly find. We had high hopes for this area, but we've definitely been rewarded with this river. It's called the Fossa River. which roughly translates in Icelandic to the waterfall river. And we're just making our way down a great series of waterfalls and rapids. There's a couple of bigger ones that have some questionable landings. We will take a little closer look at those later on today, but for now we're just gonna head off down this little section of rapids here and just soak up this country and this river. It's really a very special part of the planet. So we're in a big lake at the terminal wall of Jakobsøerlung, which is Europe's biggest glacier, and in a part of the country that's known as the iceberg forest. And it's just a huge lake full of icebergs that are all cascading off the front of the glacier. And I've paddled out here in my kayak, and it's the first time I've ever pulled up on an iceberg and had a little bit of an explore. Pretty amazing experience to be sitting at the foot of Europe's largest glacier, sitting on an iceberg that's literally floating around on its way to the ocean. It's definitely a pretty amazing place, and I guess this is one of the reasons why they call it Iceland. But this is what it's all about, you know, these kind of trips, is stepping outside of your comfort zone and what you know, and experiencing new places and new things. And I guess those things don't always have to be white water and waterfalls.